There's nobody out there Christmas except here. For Sarah Palin, who could absolutely dominate the stage, and she can't stand on the intellectual stage with Obama.
Okay, well, there you go. Thank you, panel. I can see there'll be a lump of coal.
Oh, well, there you go. Welcome back to the Laura Ingraham Radio Program. I'm Tammy Bruce, filling in for Laura. Thank you so much for letting me hang out here with you today. Today and tomorrow, as a matter of fact. For my subscribers over at TammyBruce.com, the chat room, the TAM chat room, is up and kicking right now. Just a little heads up regarding that. It'll also be up tomorrow as I fill in for Laura. And the LauraIngraham.com side, of course, is up and live, even though she's on vacation. That is regularly updated. And, you know, of course, to keep in touch with that, to say the least. Yeah, so that was Juan Williams. I'm fascinated. Now, you heard from Dana Perino, of course, is from the Bush team. And, you know, you got a bunch of liberals there. Look, I've mentioned in the past that the Bushes are liberals. And don't ever forget that George H.W. Bush was the liberal alternative to Ronald Reagan. And look, it's been liberals ever since President Reagan. That's why we're in the condition we're in right now. And this is a cadre of the establishment that is terrified of an outsider going into the White House. One of the reasons is actually just came out last week. The revelation that we are allowing thousands of businesses. We've issued, 10,000 waivers. Both the Bush and the Obama administration issued thousands of waivers for companies to do business with Iran. Ranging from, you know, there's some humanitarian aspects that we're supposed to give waivers for. But we're talking about salad dressing, hot sauce, cigarettes, chewing gum for their, quote, athletes. You know it's going to the Revolutionary Guard. GE's been doing business with them for years. One company has been bidding on getting a natural gas pipeline set up for them, an American company. When we, of course, are then going to the UN and demanding sanctions on Iran. What do you think that does to any kind of seriousness? Why, you know, a lot of times we're wondering, why is nobody taking us seriously? It's because that stuff's going on. Why do you think Iran's running around and having their parties and not caring? Because they hear us screaming at the UN, which is apparently just for our consumption. Well, then they're getting thousands of waivers, and American companies are helping a nation which has been murdering our troops. They've been shooting down American troops, and we have been allowing American companies to hold that sewer pit up. When, as if there was any morality in the world at all, we would have made it a parking lot. So now, what do you think? You know, suddenly we're in a world where some of these things are being leaked, but when that has been for the last decade, we've been giving them waivers. What else is there that we don't know? What else do you think that the ruling class knows that someone like, Sarah Palin doesn't? And that Sarah Palin would handle differently than the boys have been handling? You know, regardless, you're talking about the ultimate outsider. Mitt Romney isn't. Tim Pawlenty isn't. Bobby Jindal isn't. No one else on the list can you consider an outsider. So if you're wondering if she's meaningless, why do they go after her? Because it really has nothing to do with Sarah Palin. It has to do with the fact that she can win and that she's not of them. And this is why Tea Party exists. She happens to be the person who's the outsider. This is why we exist. To find out what in God's name has happened that has made the world run by genocidal tyrants. Why we have bin Laden in our sights during Clinton's administration and nothing happens to him. Why September 11th is possible, that it can happen. How it is that Barack Obama can win the presidency. That the Clintons would blink. That there'd be thousands of people in government and the people he surrounds himself with, Barack Obama, allow him to screw up every day. That James Clapper, the National Intelligence Director and the Secretary of Homeland Security and an advisor to the president, all sitting on television, don't think that it's a bad thing that the top guy doesn't know what's going on. How does this happen? That's the question. And what you heard from Juan Williams is especially funny. Questioning, first of all, lauding Obama's intelligence. Let me give you a little bit of a heads up here. Over at TammyBruce.com, there's a post. It's the second one down. Titled, Obama, quote, merely mimicking the mannerisms of an intellectual. This is from an interview in 2007. I've got the text and links to the actual audio of Richard Epstein, who was an Obama colleague at the University of Chicago and who still teaches there. It's Epstein that, in an interview and also to the Boston Globe, was quoted as saying, I like Obama, but I reject the suggestion that he's an intellectual. He is an activist merely mimicking the mannerisms of an intellectual. And then wondering how good is his mind. Epstein said, well, his mind is pretty good, but it's a clever means-ends mind. In other words, figuring out how to get what it is he wants. He then says he's never written a scholarly article in his entire life. He's then asked by the interviewer, well, he was a president of the Harvard Law Review. He says, well, but he never wrote an article. And Epstein says, well, if he did, it was unsigned and not academically significant. Then he was asked, would you ever give him tenure at the University of Chicago Law School? And Epstein says, no, no, no. Obama is not an intellectual. He's an actor. Why do you think he loves television so much? He is not an intellectual. He's what's known as a pretender. He goes through the motions. Let me tell you, he probably does the same thing in all of his relationships as well. It's not just for us. This is who this guy is. So when you've got somebody sitting on a panel saying Obama's an intellectual and Sarah Palin, or anybody, can't hold a candle to him intellectually, I'm just wondering, Sarah Palin is a college graduate. She's written some important things. I'm wondering, what makes Sarah Palin not an intellectual, but Barack Obama an intellectual? What really, it's fascinating. Because we know more about Sarah Palin in the last year than we will ever know about Barack Obama. Yeah. So that reveals something about Juan Williams. Yeah. The fact that they're still drinking the Kool-Aid about this guy and him being some kind of a genius. No, he's not a genius. And you know, when Juan Williams says that Sarah Palin is not on the same intellectual stage as Obama, here's my comment to that. Well, I hope not. We had better hope that every single one of the Republicans out there is not on the same intellectual stage as Barack Obama. That is exactly what we need, is someone who knows what they're doing. You know, it was one thing, it's like, well, he's a brilliant guy. He's backward. No, he's faking it. He's faking everything. Being a Christian, being the president, being a smart guy, everything is faked. I'm telling you, it may take years. It may take years, but you'll remember me saying this to you. Oh, and all of this, you know, everybody like wanting, and I know Laura's mentioned this, this notion of people trying to determine who's going to be the candidates that you guys can vote on. It's funny. The only one they seem to want out is Palin. Now, regardless of who your favorite is, you got to ask yourself why. That's what's intriguing. Why? And I think I've answered it for you. They can trust everyone else with their secrets. Yeah. Oh, and some news, you know, I think you'd already heard that Bristol Palin's bought a house in Arizona. There is some discussion now, some people guessing, that maybe the entire family is looking to move. A realtor there said he took Todd Palin around. He got the impression that the entire family was going to be going on out there. A little bit of food for thought. I do wonder, I don't imagine that Bristol Palin with her little boy would move so far away from her family. And my listeners know that I do believe Sarah Palin has been running for president. So all of you should prepare for that. And I think, frankly, just for the sake of what it means, it's a good thing. And I also think she's the best person for it, in my humble opinion. And, of course, all of that will play out. And if she's not the right one, then let everyone decide that. What's everyone so afraid of?